Dear students, welcome back to your English class. So in the previous class, we saw the chapter of Happy Prince from your supplementary. Today, let us start with the sixth chapter of your beehive, that is My Childhood. This is actually a short autobiography about APJ Abdul Kalam. I think I don't have to give you much introduction about him. You all are very well aware about him, his life story, right? At least if not anything, you know that he was one of the most renowned, well-known president of our country. So here, this story will reveal the life of, and he was also a scientist. So it will reveal the life of a scientist whose life is very influencing. Now here we will see that his journey starts from a middle-class family and ends in the president's house. This scientist is who? It's no other than Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, who is also better known as the Missile Man of India. Alright? So that was just a brief introduction about this chapter. So let us go into the story. Okay? So this lesson, you will see as you will read the text, it will tell us about Dr. Abdul Kalam's childhood. Abdul Kalam, who was one of the world's greatest scientists, was actually, you know, born in a middle-class Muslim family in 1931 at Rameshwaram. Rameshwaram is in the southern part of our country. And his journey from a middle-class family in Rameshwaram to the president's house had not been a smooth ride. In fact, there were lots of challenges, difficulties, obstacles that he had to come across. And he took over, you know, he was very well able to handle all those situations, and that is where, that as a result, that is where he ended as being the president of our country. He worked hard and faced all the odds of life. He was born in a conservative society. You know what is conservative? Where the people, the, you know, kind of this, what do you call, the society, the parents, they have a conservative thinking. Thinking related to old culture, old tradition, old norms, that is called conservative. And his family, as well as his teachers and his friends, they were all influenced. They all influenced him in his childhood, I would say that. The name of his father was Jainul Abidin. His father, Jainul Abidin, was not much educated. But even though he was not much educated, he was very generous and a kind person. He was not rich, but he provided Abdul a happy and a secure childhood. In fact, Abdul inherited honesty and self-discipline from his father. When Abdul was young, he earned his first wages by working as a helping hand to his cousin, whose name was Samsuddin. Now, Samsuddin used to distribute newspaper in Rameshwaram. And as a result, Abdul decided to be a helping hand to him, and that is how he earned his first wages. He was also influenced by some of his friends and teachers. He had three close friends. One is Ramananda Shastri. The other one was Arvindam and Shiva Prakasan. So these three are his close friends: Ramananda Shastri, Arvindam and Shiva Prakasan. When Abdul was in fifth standard, a new teacher came to his school, and this new teacher hurt his feelings by ordering him to sit away from this high caste Brahmin boys. So he really felt sad with this behavior of his teacher. But there was another teacher, a science teacher, and Abdul was deeply influenced by his science teacher, whose name was Siva Subramanya Iyer. Now, Siva Subramanya Iyer taught him lesson of breaking social barriers. You know, in our society, social society, we have different types of barriers. Barriers in the name of religion, barriers in the name of caste, barriers in the name of class, rich, poor, Hindu, Muslim, Christian, and so on, many barriers. But it was his science teacher who taught him, you know, that one must go beyond these barriers. And in fact, one day it so happened that his science teacher served him food and sat down beside him, even though his orthodox wife opposed to do so. The wife of the science teacher was a very much orthodox, and his wife opposed when Siva Subramani Iyer sat with Abdul for the meal. Now, Abdul, being grown up, when he grew up, his father permitted him for higher studies and sent him to the district headquarters, which is in Ramanathapuram. His father said, okay, listen properly, his father said that, Abdul, I know you have to go away and grow. See, his father said what? I know you have to go away and grow. And that is when his journey from a common student to a prominent scientist and then being the president of India, it began. So this, as I told you in the beginning itself, this is a short autobiography about the life of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. And you know, this story, what do we learn from this story? It conveys many messages. First of all, we should learn good points from others. In life, you will come across different types of people, different types of scenarios. You must learn, but always grab the good things. Second, we also learn that our parents are our best guide. We must give them respect and follow their advice. And the most important message that we get from this chapter is that we should not make any difference between religions, because see, this, there may be different religions, but if you observe keenly, you will find that all these religions, they teach the same lesson to all. And one can achieve his or her goal if, you know, if he or she is completely dedicated to hard work, and also must have the willingness to sacrifice our wants. If you cannot sacrifice, see, there's a simple saying, in order to get something, you have to give something. So if you don't have the willingness to sacrifice your wants, it'll be difficult for you to achieve your goal. And another lesson, another message that we get from this story is that we must have love for our country. In fact, our country is above all our desires. So I hope you got the story, right? Just go through the text. And if you find any difficulty, any query if you have, you can get back to me. Okay? I repeat once again, the main theme. What is the main theme of the story? As I told you just now in the message, it's based on harmony. Okay? And also the many prejudice that is present in our society, present in our Indian society. So this is mainly about his childhood days. Okay, and we can rise in life if we have what? Strong determination and dedication. So with this, I end this class. Just go through the text, read the text thoroughly. God bless you.